When Allah complains about the lack of obedience of the human being, He compares us to the rest of the universe. So for example, سَبَّحَ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Right? Everything in the heavens and the earth is declaring Allah's perfection. How is a rock? How is the moon? How is the sun? How is the sky declaring Allah's perfection? Allah tells us, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Is there anything in existence except that it's declaring the perfection of your Lord by praising Him? But you don't understand the way they do so. You don't understand that language. So that tree, that blade of grass outside, the breeze of air we feel on our face, all of these are declaring Allah's perfection. They are in obedience to Allah and praising Him, complying to His command. We simply don't understand how. We are the only one, by the way, that Allah commands and He has the option to listen. لَهُ خِيَار, right? He has got some choice. Us and the jinn. But the rest of the creation, when Allah commands, they listen. They listen. You know, human beings, shouldn't they be intently listening to the commandment of their Lord? And when they listen to that commandment, shouldn't they be obeying immediately to what their Lord said? After all, He is their Lord. But in the previous surah we found, وَمَا يُكَذِّبُ بِهِ إِلَّا كُلُّ مُعْتَدْ أَثِيمٌ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٌ. Two attributes of this rebellious human being we found. One who crosses the lines. He's told, don't cross this line, he crosses it. He's told, don't do this, he does it. He's told, do this, he doesn't do it. And he's constantly engaged in sin. Constantly engaged in sin. This is a theme here. Ya ayyuhal insan. Allah Azza wa Jal begins, Ya ayyuhal insan. This usloob, this style of, oh human being. Hey human being. An insan, you know, from one of the origins of the word insan is nasiya. So one of the implications of that is, oh forgetful human being. You forgot where you came from. You forgot your journey, your destiny. The earth didn't forget. The sky didn't forget. You forgot. And so from the word even insan, we get this idea of, you know, nisyan, of forgetfulness. Now this thing has been mentioned twice. Ya ayyuhal insan occurs twice. And both in these series of surahs, you have Ya ayyuhal insan innaka kadih. Then we have Ya ayyuhal insan, we read already, Ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. Oh human being, what deluded you from your gracious Lord? What was so powerful that deceived you? We've read that already. So now we find the other statement from Ya ayyuhal insan, tying these two surahs together, even in their style. Innaka kadihun. No doubt you are engaged, you are actively engaged. This is ism fa'il, so it's active engagement. You're actively engaged in toiling labor. You're actively engaged in toiling labor. Before we go any further, let's understand what that means. You know, in another place Allah says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. We created the human being in just harsh work. So that one of the conditions, it's a fact of life. Human beings, our entire life is struggling for things. It's struggling for things. Think of your entire life like exits or milestones on a highway. Right? You run out of gas, you got to get to the gas station, then you got to get to the next one. Destination you forget about, you worry more about how you get to the next milestone. Right?